Hello, in this quick video, we're going to take a look at how to join and use a Zoom meeting. To begin, your instructor should have shared with you a meeting invitation or join URL. Using this information, navigate to the URL in a web browser. While you can use the Zoom app on your mobile device and Wi-Fi, we do not recommend these options. Using a wired internet connection on a computer will give you the most stable meeting experience. Once the meeting page loads, you will be prompted to download and run the Zoom client. Save this file to your computer and follow the setup instructions on the screen. Once the client has successfully installed, your meeting will launch. If the client does not work properly, click on the link at the bottom of the page to run the lighter version of the Zoom meeting from your browser. Once the meeting launches, you will be asked to connect to the meeting audio. Select if you'd like to connect with your phone or with your computer microphone and speakers. If you choose to connect with your computer, we recommend testing your mic and speakers using the testing tool provided. As always, please use a headset or headphones in order to help avoid audio feedback. Once your audio is connected, you can mute and unmute yourself at any time by clicking the microphone button at the bottom of the screen. We recommend muting your mic if you're not speaking to help avoid any audio issues for the rest of the meeting participants. To start sharing your camera, click on the video button at the bottom of the screen. You can also stop sharing your camera by clicking on this button. Once the meeting has started, you'll have some control over what you see. You can view everyone's cameras in speaker view, which highlights the active speaker as the largest camera, or switch to gallery view. Gallery view shows all of the cameras on one screen and highlights the active speaker with a border around their camera. You can also click on the full screen button to maximize the viewing space. Along the bottom of the meeting room are some additional options you'll find handy. The first is the participants list, which will show you who else is in the meeting. There's also the chat option, which lets you send messages to other users in the room. Clicking on the chat option brings up the chat panel. This can be helpful if you're having technology issues or want to ask a question without interrupting the current speaker. And that's it! All you need to know about the basics of getting started and using Zoom. If you have any questions or concerns, please contact the UTech Service Desk at 368-HELP or at help.case.edu. Thanks for watching!